In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your
spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment to acknowledge our sins, so that we may prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
So the 12 called together the community of shall devote ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word. The proposal was accepted to the whole community. So they chose Stephen, a man filled with faith and the Holy Spirit. Also Philip, Prochorus, Nicanor, Timon, Parmenas, and Nicholas of Antioch, a convert to Judaism. They presented these men to the apostles, who prayed and laid hands on them. The word of God continued to spread, and even the number of disciples in Jerusalem increased greatly. Even a large group of priests were becoming obedient to the faith. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Disobeying the word, as is their destiny. You are a chosen race, a
according to John.
Grace, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God. Have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I am going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to myself, so that where I am, you may also be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, then you will also know my Father. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Master, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you for so long a time, and you still do not know me, Philip? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me? The words that I speak to you, I do not speak on my own. The Father who dwells in me is doing his work. Believe me that I am in the Father, and the Father is in me, or else believe because of the works themselves. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes in me will do the works that I do, and will do greater ones than these, because I am going to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In today's Gospel, Jesus reminds us that he and the Father are one. He is in the Father, and the Father is in him. But before Jesus proclaimed that, made that proclamation to his disciples, he was born of a woman. He was born of our Blessed Mother, Mary. He was born in the tabernacle of her womb and became the food that we eat and the food that we love for, the food that we long for, the food that sustains us in every single day of our lives. Now, I know in the last couple months we have not received that food that provides us eternal life while still here on earth and ultimately gets us to heaven, but it is something that many of us long for, and soon enough we will receive him once again. But before he did his ministry, his mother took care of him. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, and people from all around came to see this newborn king. He was not born in a big palace with fancy clothing or fancy jewels. He was born of a common woman and a common man. He was humble enough to live the life of a servant and serve many people along the way. And he still continues to serve us today. And sometimes when we're little kids, we scrape our knee or scrape our hand or something on it, and our dad tries to help us, but dad cannot fix that for us. Sometimes it helps with a mother's loving care to kiss our wound or our boo-boo or whatever you call it. But when we run to our mother in our time of need, she takes care of us. In the same way, when we are in need of something, we can run to our Mother Mary and ask her for her intercessory prayers to pray on our behalf so that we too can be healed. I always tell people, pray for me because I need all the help I can get. Pray to I ask the poor souls in purgatory to pray for me as well, because all of us need all the help we can get. But in your time of need, in your day-to-day life, when you feel like you're lost, go to your mother. Say a simple Hail Mary, or "My Holy Mother, help me in my time of need," or "Holy Mother, help me in my way," or "Holy Mother, can you just pray for me today? You know the things that have been heavily upon my heart." Today is a day we honor all mothers throughout the world, living and deceased, those who are here on earth with us, and those that are in heaven. Today we give thanks to them for all that they have done for us. And today we honor them simply by saying thank you and love you. Those of you who are watching and your mother is there with you, Place your hand upon her shoulder and remind her that you love her. And bow with us all, take a moment and bow our heads in prayer as we offer a blessing for our mothers. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women, that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the examples of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters, with one voice, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, unmade, consubstantial of the Father. Through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from our Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Trusting our Heavenly Father, on behalf of the intercessory prayers of our Blessed Mother, let us offer our prayers to the Lord.
For all of us baptized into Christ's Church and the royal priesthood, may the Lord continue to increase our faith for the sake of his kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all in position of authority, may God's grace enable them to lead with integrity, protecting life from conception to natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For any who are struggling to believe and those whose faith is weak, may Christ speak to their troubling hearts and give them hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have been welcomed into the church this Easter season, may the Holy Spirit continue to form them as living stones. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, may he who has prepared a place for them welcome them into the splendor of their heavenly home. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. For those who are suffering through this current pandemic, we offer our prayers. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all the intentions we hold deeply in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, hear the prayers in which we have presented here before you. May they be answered in due time according to your will through Christ our Lord.
I will come to you.
expected in this sacrifice. May it make us partakers of the one supreme Godhead. Grant, we pray, that as we come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, by rising, restored our life. Therefore, O come with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together again in the hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Charles our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs through eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Thank you. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom and the power and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," live not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For those who are not able to receive Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament, we offer our prayer of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament, and I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Thank you.
The Mass is ended. Let us all in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Have a great week.